Okay, here are your solutions, guys. Hopefully you've tried all the problems and you're just here to check answers. That being said, I'm going to go fairly quickly when working these through, so that I don't waste your time, okay? And I'm going to show all my work. If you need to stop and rewind, pause, anything like that, feel free to do so. But for the most part, I'm only going to talk through it if I think it's like super tricky. Which so far, this is not super tricky. This is actually going really nice and fast. Okay. So here's one of those that's a what I call the complex compound fraction. And here I'm going to need to work in the denominator first. So a common denominator would be 8, which makes that a 2 plus a 5, which is a 7. Now we can multiply by the reciprocal. Nothing cancels. So that would be our answer on number 3. Okay, number 4, same idea, but now the fraction is in the numerator. So I'm going to deal with that first. Have a common denominator of 16, which makes that a 29, and over 1/4. I'm going to go ahead and bring that up and save a little time. Reduce to a 4. So 29 over 4 would be the answer there. Hopefully you can read my writing. I'm trying my best here. Number 5. Okay. This was not in the notes, and that was on purpose. I wanted to see, what we remembered with combining radicals. On this type of a problem, gang, you have got to remember that nothing combines unless those match. So to make those match, you're going to need to reduce this radical first, which means if you can make it a square root of 5, then do so. So this breaks down to 9 times 5. Which means that this will be this 3 times 3 root 5. So I think we all remember how to break down a radical. And that means that this is a negative 2 root 5 plus 9 root 5, which makes it a 7 root 5. And that's how you're going to handle a problem like that. Try to get matching bases if possible, and then work the problem. Now, I'll tell you right now, that one looks tricky, but this one hopefully gives me a hint. A cubed root of a negative is perfectly legal, okay, because it's an odd root, and a negative times a negative times a negative does make a negative. So, like this entire thing, we will be able to break down. I just got to figure out how it's going to break down. If you don't remember how to handle a cubed root, just think of things that are cubed and try to make this happen. Like, this is an 8, 3 to the third is 27, 4 to the third. Okay, so if any of these goes into that, then we'll break it down, which this one does. So let's see, this is 8 times 6. So this whole thing is going to break down into negative 2, and then there'll still be a cubed root of 6 left over, okay? And then there's still that minus in the front, which makes this a positive. Hopefully, y'all got that. This is a negative, but there's a negative in the front, so it's a positive. This, I don't know how to break it down, but this 6 is going to give me a clue. So I'm going to go ahead and just see 6 times what, see if it goes into that, okay? Because it gave me a clue. So 6 goes into 16 twice. That would be a 42. There we go. So 6 times 27 is how that breaks down. Now, what that means is that the cubed root of 27 is 3 if I look over to the side. So this is going to be negative 3 times 3 cubed root of 6. And then we can do just like we did over here. I'm going to put my coefficients together. That's a negative 9. That's a positive 2. So now it's a negative 7 cubed root of 6. So putting together expressions with radicals, always important to know. All right. We are going to move on to the next stuff, which is writing radicals in exponential form. Okay, so we've got the cubed root of 7k all to the fourth, and this pretty much is exactly like our notes guide. You're just gonna have to roll through these and make sure you understand how to rewrite. And This one might be a little tricky if you forgot that anything in a denominator, this is just a rule with exponents, if you want to pull it out of the denominator, you can, as long as you make this a negative. So this is equivalent to the fourth root of 26 all to the negative third power, and then it's no longer in the denominator, and then we can just do the fourth, is that a 6 or a b? I think it's a b, my bad. So the fourth root of 2b, it's not what I wanted to do, sorry. I'm trying to write it as an exponent. Okay, so 2b to the negative 3/4. That's how that one can be handled. Number 10, that is super easy, and I know you're like, why did she put that on there? This is stupid easy. Okay, this is all over the place in calculus. Like, I'm talking almost daily, you will have to rewrite this as this, and students get stumped, and they're like, wait, I don't know what to do with this, and I'm always having to say, rewrite it, and then you will know. So, you'll see as we get into the calculus stuff this summer, why that is, like, extremely important. Okie dokie. And now, the factoring. Now, these might take me a little time to think about. I have not done this ahead of time. So I will be factoring in real time. I always look for what can I take out that is common to everybody, right? And so I know that 6 goes into all of those numbers. I also know that there's an n squared, and I also know that I hate that negative. So my first step would be to take out a negative 6n squared from everybody, which leaves an n squared here. 6 goes into 72 12 times, so minus 12n, and then 6 goes into 210, what is that, 335 times, and then I can just recopy this in the front and just try to factor what's left here, which that looks like it's a nice, like, what, 7 times 5, 7, good, minus 7, minus 5. Okay, so that is how that one works. All right. Now we're rolling. Number 12, negative x squared plus 8x plus 20. Same thing, guys. I hate negatives in the front. It jacks with me. It messes with my head. I would just take that out of all three terms initially, then try to factor, and usually this works for me. Okay, two numbers that multiply here, but then have to form a negative 8. So I'm thinking 10 and 2, and I would need the 10 to be negative and the 2 to be positive. Number 13, 5n cubed plus 45n squared plus 40n. Okay, 5 definitely goes into all those, and there's an n in all of those. So this will become an n squared plus a 9n plus an 8. And from here, it's a piece of cake. This one's really easy. Woo! As long as you knew to take out the greatest common factor, that is super duper easy as well. Okay, 14x to the third plus 4x squared. What's common to both of those? Well, an x squared is. And you are done. Okay, number 15, negative 7r cubed plus 41r squared plus 56r. Okay, gonna take out, 7 does not go into, nothing goes into those. There is an r and there's a negative. I'm gonna take out a negative r just so I don't have a negative in the front, right? So this is actually a 7r squared minus 41r minus 56. And I'm gonna try to work with this instead. And hopefully I can make this happen. And y'all, I'm a guess and check girl, so you're gonna see me guessing and checking. Now the only way to make 7 is with a 7 and a 1. And 56, as a couple numbers come into mind. The two main ones, of course, are 8 and 7. So if I could have an 8 and a 7, let me think about this. I think I can do this, 8 and 7, because 7 times 7 is 49. And then I can add 8 to that. So I want to subtract the 49, but then add 8 back, and that should give me what's in the middle there. So the science here is just, I mean, it really is guess and check. It's knowing your multiplication quick enough to, and your FOIL, so that you could sort of do this backwards in your head like I did. Okay? Hopefully you guys got through that. You might not have been as quick as me, but I'm awesome, so JK. All right, so la la la, what goes into this? Okay, so 35, I don't know if it goes into these numbers. Okay, I'm going to just do this one step at a time. Let me take out a negative 5 first. 5 goes in here, is that 40 times? And then 5 goes in there 63 times. Okay, yeah, nothing else is coming out of there. I started small just because I didn't know, and sure enough, that's as far as I could go. And now I'm doing the same thing I did a second ago. I'm going to try to reason through this. So 63, you should be thinking of what? 9 times 7, and we need a 40. So nah, it's going to be the same as the last one. That's kind of cheap. We're going to need to subtract this to get a negative 49. And then we're going to need to add 9 back to it to get that in the middle. So that would be factoring. All right, the only one left is 17. And for some of you that are like the rest of this, you were like, this is so lame. This is so easy. This may be the only part of this video that you're actually watching. So if that's you, hello. Welcome to the party. And what we're going to do is I'm going to quickly cruise through all of these problems, right? So we're going to do f plus g of x. Here we're just adding. So I've got a 3x, I've got a negative 1 here, and a positive 5 here, so that's actually a plus 4, and then a minus square root of x. So that's how I would actually write that answer. We've got g of f of x, okay, which means that we are going to plug f into g. So if we're plugging f into g, it's going to be 5 minus the square root of all of that. The next one would be f of g of x. So now we go the other way. Everybody that's g gets plugged into f. So it's 3 times all this mess minus 1. I wouldn't even distribute. I mean, if you want to, I've seen some teachers that are like, simplify. So that would be like 15 minus 3 root x minus 1, which is 14 minus 3 root x. So some people might want you to take it that far, okay? F of g of x. The next one is g of 2. These are fun. I love these. Start from the back and then work your way forward. So let's first start with plugging a 2 into g. When we plug a 2 into g, we get 5 minus root 2, okay? So g of 2, I just recopied right here. I just plugged in a 2, okay? Now, all of this gets plugged into g again. So it's 5 minus the square root of 5 minus root 2. Now, that is ugly, and I am not even going to think about simplifying it. Like, that's as far as my brain understands how to go. And the last one is g of 4 over f of 4. Okay, so what this means is we're going to plug 4 into both functions, then we'll put them together with a division. So g of 4 would be 5 minus root 4, f of 4 would be 3 times 4 minus 1, and now we simplify. That would be a 3 on top, and that would be an 11 in the bottom. So good times. Hopefully that went pretty well for you, and we'll talk about more interesting kinds of factoring maybe with trig when we do our tutorial.